Okay, hi guys, welcome to another Davinci Resolve tutorial coming from Neil at Slice Pictures. So today we're going to look at the scene cut detection tool that comes with Davinci Resolve. This is quite a useful tool if you're working on a project that you've already cut and you want to basically, once you've had a master version, you want to go back and maybe regrade it something else, or just play around with it a little bit. And then from that, I'm probably going to look a little bit at creating a nice contrast with your work. So a couple of things. Excuse me, I've got a little bit of a cough. Hopefully it won't cough too many times during this. Okay, so let's just get started. And, I'm using a Mac today. Basically because I'm not in my edit suite, so I'm off on a different location at the moment. So it's maybe a little bit noisy, and it's quite an old MacBook Pro, and a little bit slow. So it took a little while to actually get DaVinci to work. But anyway, so I've got this small documentary kind of thing that I did with some students of mine last semester. And we did a master of this, ungraded master of this. So what we can do is, there's a really great little tool, is we can go into DaVinci here in our library, in our media, and we can hit the scene cut detection. Now, when the computer decides to come up, it's come up. I'm using the split screen at the moment, so it did actually come up pretty quick, but it's come up on my other screen. Okay, so because I'm using a split screen, it's thrown the scene detection onto my other screen, which is really great, thanks so much. So, but I mean, this is it, this is what it looks like, scene detect. It should, if you're working on the one monitor, it will just come up on top of the dissolve layout, so it won't come up on anything else. Anyway, all you've got to do is basically hit start, and it's going to go through it as quickly as it feels it wants to go through it. So I will come back to this again once it's finished. Okay, so we've got to 100%, which is very good. What we can see is with these green lines are where our cuts are occurring. So these are our stray cuts, so there's no transition or anything in there. And these grey sections are obviously, DaVinci's recognized something's cut, but it said, you know, you can't really turn it into a cut point because, you know, it's a dissolve. So ideally, what you would want to do is, if you're going to use this tool, is when you make your master clip or your master file, don't put any transitions in it. So you just go cut point, cut point, cut point, cut point. Don't put any transitions in, deal with that after you've done everything. so all these green sections are your main cut points that you can work with, as we can see here. So we can see on the right hand side, scene, frame, start, time code, which is quite useful. So it's been cut into 20 scenes, which is very useful. And actually there's one here that's a dissolve that I just put in myself, just to show you as an example of, you can actually add your own cuts in if you want to. So there's one here, so we see a dissolve going on. So if you wanted to add one, go to the little scene, the left bottom corner, there's a little plus, it says add a scene at the current frame. So obviously if for some reason DaVinci misses it, then you can add in your cut point just by hitting the cut. And if you want to remove any cut points, then just, you know, you just go that particular frame. So 11, for example, you would then just go there and hit the minus key, and that's it, you're done. So that's scene detect. So then all you have to do is hit the add cut to the media pool. And when you click that, that will basically just put all of these cut points, so all of these scenes, it will put them straight into your media pool. So we are ready to move on to our grade, which, you know, if you don't want to work with XMLs, you don't want to work with EDLs because maybe they're a bit funny sometimes, you know, they might have a problem communicating properly what you need it to sort of do, especially with speeds and stuff like that. Make your edit, don't put any transitions in it. Export it out, drop it into DaVinci, do the scene cut detection tool from in here, and then, you know, so do this one, and there you go, you know, you've got your cut version ready to grade, and you don't need to worry about working with EDLs and XLRs. And this is slightly, you know, maybe it's quicker, I don't know, maybe it's slower, I'm not too sure really. I've not sort of done a time difference on how quickly or slowly it works. So obviously we've got our clips, we move into our edit. And again, you know, get a fast computer, or at least get a computer that works. So we don't have a timeline in here, so we want to add a timeline. So create new timeline, you can right click in this and create a new timeline. Yes, I want to create a new timeline. There's our video, there's our audio. So we select them all, Command A on the Mac, and then we can insert or append or even force conform, but we're just going to insert all the selected clips into the timeline. Anyway, so there's our edit. So this is basically, I mean, it's the same as if I was to dump in the original, but it means I can work with each individual clip. If I want to edit a little bit, I can actually edit as well in DaVinci. I can add my own transitions. Yeah, so if I wanted to go in and put in my transitions now, then I can actually go in and do it, which is really cool. If I wanted to add some text, you know, I can do that as well, and any color bars or anything like that, then, you know, I can go in and insert all of those, and I can do it in DaVinci. I don't have to do it, you know, in Pro and Premiere or Final Cut or anything like that. So I can make my master edit and I'm done, you know. I can just make it come into DaVinci, add in my transitions I wanted to put in any extra text I might want to put in. Obviously I don't need to, but, and then move on and do my grading. But obviously I don't want to do my transitions probably until I've done my grades anyway. So we'll move on to our color and see how fast this computer is going to work. Wow, refreshing memories. Going to work as slow as I can possibly work. Wow, so fast. Okay, let's find the clip of an interview because that looks fine. Okay, cool. And so let's have a look at contrast. Creating some contrast. Obviously this has got blown out, a bit blown out whites in it, so it's probably not going to be as good as you want it to be. So I want to look at my scopes, so we can go to view and view my scopes, so video scopes on and off. Let's switch them on and I can move them onto this screen because they've jumped up on the other screen. Obviously this is, because I've separated this window, I've made a standalone window. If you want to know how to do that, you can go to view and then right at the bottom of view it says show window frame. So you can do that and it skips the whole of DaVinci onto a window so you can move it around a bit. Quite useful. That's how I did this. So I've got that. I can change to my one up and look at my lovely waveform and obviously find my blacks and whites, and this is clipping kind of a little bit in the black, but, and let's see what happens if I pull up my black a little bit. Yeah, you can see like that was pretty flat along the bottom, that one, so we'll pull that one down, not too much though. So I want to leave a little bit. Whoa, let's not do that. Thank you very much. Okay, so I'm gonna leave a little bit at the bottom here, just so there's not on the blacks. The whites are okay. I mean, it's clipping a little bit on the gain. So if we want to pull down the gain a little bit, we can. Get it in between the broadcast levels, really. That's what you kind of want anyway. So that's cool. So I'm going to add a node, which is Alt and S on both, on the Mac and the PC, that's the same. So, I mean, what we can do is possibly switch off this, so we gang custom curves. Now, if we gang it, that basically means whatever I do in here works in all of them. Yeah, so I'm working with all three, four layers of curves. But if I switch the gang off, that means I can work independently with like my red, if I only want to work on my red and have some more red in there, or pull out a little green and then make it look really weird. But you can work kind of independently with it. So what's pretty cool with curves is obviously we're a bit blown out. So we could probably pull out the mid-tone a little bit, pull down the blacks, but not too much, you know, if it just look a bit funny, and then pull out the whites. And again, like not too much, because else this is going to blow out like crazy. So if we up the mid-tones a little bit, like so, and pull down the blacks a little bit, you know, we're creating a basic kind of contrast look. So it's just really slow, isn't it? Oh my god. So without and with, so it's given it a little bit of depth. Bit more contrast going on in there, a bit darker in the looks. And looking a little bit stronger. What you could do is just, you know, add some effect into it. If you wanted to do a shape around his face, you know, to pull some of this colouring out. But, you know, whatever. I mean, contrast is really easy to create, right? Because it's all about just, you know, you could do an S-curve. So if we reset that and you did like a basic S-curve, let's move to another clip. Which might be better. Let's have a look at this. It looks a bit flat and slightly better to play with. So if we do a typical, you know, S curve, so the highlights come up, the lows come down, obviously way, way, way too much. I mean, that's kind of your, like, you know, typical S curve. Contrast, maybe a little bit high in the whites. So that's your kind of like typical, if I reset it, you can see if I'll do it on another node, and do the same on another node, so pull this down a little bit, blow out the whites, maybe push out the mids a bit. Not too much contrast, so you just can't see it, you know. Let's move this mid-frame a bit. Okay. So, without, obviously, just like no kind of grading to it. And there's the with contrast. So it's a little bit punchier. And that's kind of your standard S-curve. If you wanted to do it, you could do it with the gains as well, lift gamma gain, you know, you can pull your black down. You can see what's happening, you're just pulling the black down, like minus 2 it's at the moment, minus 7 there, probably too dark, but then if you pushed your mids up a little bit, maybe a couple of drops up, maybe to 3 or 4, and then you did the same with the whites up to like 2 or 3. Wow, that's 12. Okay, well, maybe 1 back, 10, 9. Okay, we can sort of see it's like the same effect creating contrast, so without, kind of flat, and then with a bit more contrasty. So that's, you know, a few different ways. So you can do the S-curve with the luminance in here. You can work with the lift gamma gain in there. So there's two ways you can play with contrast. All right. If you like that, then you know you can grab a still. That'll throw the still in here, and then you can go into maybe this one, you know, and just dump that on top of it, and it creates that sort of contrasty-esque effect, looking at effect, so let's take it off, let's put it on. Yeah, it looks a bit punchier, so it's quite flat there, a bit punchier. That's cool. So, there we go. Hopefully that's quick, because, like, you know, this computer's really slow and bugging me now. So hopefully that's useful. So we looked at the scene cut detection tool quickly, and then two ways that we can kind of create contrast very easily working in DaVinci Resolve. All right, I will be back with another tutorial soon, and I hope you enjoyed this one. Enjoy.